What's up, guys, and welcome to the channel. I'm JNO, and welcome to my team review, where I go over my team's performance in game week 13, which wasn't very good, and hopefully look into the future for what I'm going to do for game week 14. But we do try and split this into two parts. So I say try. I've been trying to split this into two parts for the last 2 or 3 weeks. The plan is moving forward to have two my team videos, one looking back at game week 13 and talking generally about my plans for the future, and then another episode which I release which focuses in on the transfers I'm planning to make and looking at the fixtures moving forward. So hopefully this week, as I'm recording this on Tuesday, should get the second part of my team up on around Thursday is the hope. Fingers crossed. But before we get into this video, if you do want Fantasy Premier League content in your subscription box, consider subscribing to this channel, hitting the notification bell so you're told when my videos go live, and let's get on with the video. So I managed to get 39 points from game week 13 when the average was 50. One of the most disappointing game weeks I think I've had in my memory of doing this on YouTube, at least. Basically, everything just went wrong. We had two players actually returning decent points. Wan-Bissaka was 6 points on the bench as the third substitute, and only Mohamed Salah and Andrew Robertson from Liverpool actually doing anything for me. And the issue with it all was Matthew Ryan could have got a clean sheet. Leicester were a man down, and then Leicester still somehow managed to score against Brighton. Chelsea just didn't turn up against Spurs. Who saw Wolves getting dominated by Huddersfield? And then Jimenez was inches away from scoring a goal after I transferred him in as well. But if we go into more detail into my players, were the underlying stats at least promising moving forward, or is my team in a dire need of restructuring? But before we do that, my overall rank is now 38,416th, a drop of about 18,000 places thanks to the performance of game week 13. Now on 818 points, and my game week rank was 4.8652 million. That is really, really bad, and it saw red arrows across the board naturally. So looking at my goalkeeper and defence, first of all, you can see that my transfer in was Andrew Robertson in yellow. At 6.5 million, he was the only defender to return points. Mr. Consistency, Marcus Alonso at 7.1, didn't actually perform to his usual standards of getting a clean sheet or some sort of attacking return with only 1 point. Doherty, only 1 point after Huddersfield just dominated Wolves. Although Wolves did have opportunities to score, which unfortunately they didn't put any away. And Matthew Ryan, clean sheets have dried up. Another 2 points for Matthew Ryan, 2 save points. But the one to focus on is Andrew Robertson. 7 points from 90 minutes played, 1 bonus point, got the clean sheet, 4 penalty area touches, which is higher than Marcus Alonso, which is usually not the case. 1 chance created, which was a big chance as well. So he could have potentially got an assist. And Liverpool's defence definitely looked decent moving forward, even with some tough fixtures in the Christmas period. Doherty actually had the most penalty area touches, at least supporting the fact that he is one of the most attacking fullbacks in the league. But it's Marcus Alonso with only 2 penalty area touches and 1 attempt on goal, which is a little bit worrying as far as an attacking standpoint from defence. But Chelsea Spurs is one of those games that you never know what's going to happen, so fair enough for not getting the clean sheet there. And I'm hoping Wolves can turn this around and it wasn't just a really good start to the season for Wolves, because I've got 3 Wolves players in my side right now because they had some decent fixtures around the corner. Moving on to the midfield, and you can see that my captain was Mohamed Salah in green, which means I did manage to double 8 points to 16. Otherwise, this game week would have been even worse. He only played 85 minutes, and strictly speaking, if there hadn't been a sending off, he might have played the full 90, and he might have been in the right position to score that third goal for Liverpool. But we got 1 goal from Mohamed Salah, 5 penalty area touches, 2 attempts on goal, 2 from inside the box, and 2 on target. So not too bad, although he was outperformed by Mane this game week, so the debate about Mane versus Salah will kick back into force. And then my transfer in was Richarlison, which, compared to Madison, was a good transfer, purely because Madison got sent off. I was considering keeping Madison because I heard he might play, but I think the transfer paid off. I did take a -4 with 3 transfers. You'll see the other one in the striker position. But overall, my transfers were better than the players I transferred out, so I can't argue too much with it. I am a bit gutted in myself that I brought Richarlison in for Cardiff, when I personally think Richarlison hasn't been that impressive with the underlying stats, so I assume the goals and assists would dry up at some point. But Richarlison, 3 points from 90 minutes played, 4 penalty area touches, 2 attempts on goal, both from inside the box and both on target, with 1 chance created. I'm looking to see what he can do for me. Brought him in to cover the ownership because I was very worried that if he banged against Cardiff, then I would be in trouble. I was in trouble anyway, but imagine he'd banged and I had Madison. This game week would have been even worse. Hazard, 1 point. Everyone is moving Hazard on. There is a slight concern about him playing in the next game week as well. It was against Spurs, so it's a hard game to judge. I don't think he was getting the supply he needs. In the FPL Wildcat stream, we were debating if he plays better with Giroud as well than he does with Morata. I may not make a transfer this week purely because I'm not 100% sure I'll be in the right frame of mind after a bad game week to make a move that will make sense. But Hazard is definitely one I'm considering putting on the chopping block. Mainly because I feel like Mohamed Salah, I need Liverpool coverage. And I think Mohamed Salah could still be season-long the best Liverpool option. Whereas potentially I'm looking at Chelsea thinking if Hazard isn't performing that well, I'm not sure there's anyone in that side I really, really want. And then Ryan Fraser, 6.2 million. Didn't get anything against Arsenal, unfortunately. 90 minutes played, one penalty area touch, one attempt on goal, which was on target. He's cheap. I've got to remember he's 6.2 million. So I know I was hoping a lot for him to do something purely because Saturday had been so bad. So I was hoping for some points on Sunday. But I think Ryan Fraser still... I could, of course, move to Brooks. He could have scored if he hadn't been offside a couple of times, which would give me money to spend elsewhere, which is a consideration of mine. But Fraser at 6.2 million, I can't expect him to perform for me every week. So I can forgive 2 points from Fraser more than I can forgive 1 point from Hazard. And then moving up front, we can see Jimenez is the guy I brought in for Danny Ings at 5.9 million. Now, Danny Ings, of course, didn't play. So 2 points just means I lost 2 points overall on what I would have scored if I'd just stuck with Ings. Which isn't great, but it isn't as costly a transfer as it could have been. And if Jimenez had got that header over the goal line, then I would potentially be looking at a very good transfer and one that could have helped my game week a little bit. But 90 minutes played, 6 penalty area touches, 5 attempts on goal, 4 from inside the box, only 1 shot on target out of all of that. And the issue I have with Jimenez is he just didn't look calm in front of goal. When he doesn't have long to think about the chance, he looked okay, like the header. But when he had time to think about the chance, there was a time when he was played through because a Huddersfield defender was down, so he was onside behind most of the Huddersfield defence. He just didn't seem to know what to do with the ball, and he didn't even get a shot away, so very concerned about the Jimenez transfer already, which is very worrying. Aguero was missing in that thrashing of West Ham. Sterling, Sane, Silva, all of them look more likely of scoring. And plenty of times the ball was put into the box and I'm thinking, where was Aguero? So I'm very worried about Aguero now. And with Kane having good fixtures around the corner and the three behind Kane returning, Ali, Son and Christian Eriksen, I am considering Aguero moving on as well. Then Callum Wilson, not the best performance from him, outshined by Joshua King. 5 penalty area touches, 2 attempts on goal, 2 from inside the box, 1 on target from 90 minutes played, 2 points only. Again, it was a tough fixture for Bournemouth. I was hoping for something. I will probably give Wilson a little bit more time purely because I'm more worried about Jimenez and Aguero at the moment. So that is it for my team review of the stats and performance from game week 13. Overall, you can see that the positions I am worried about right now are two of my strikers, Aguero and Jimenez. But Aguero against Bournemouth next, it's unlikely I'm going to transfer him out for that one. Jimenez was brought in because of good fixtures and as a replacement to Ings, and I can't really afford to upgrade him. Midfield, I have gone with Richarlison. I think I'll give him a bit of time before I transfer him out. Fraser, cheap, so I'm not too bothered about him. Salah, I think I'm keeping despite his price tag because I'm more concerned about Hazard, to be fair. I think Salah is always capable of scoring goals because of the amount of chances he has. Hazard hasn't looked the same as he did at the beginning of the season. So Hazard to Sterling or Sane could be a move I make. And then in the defence, I don't want two Wolves defenders anymore. So Bennett may be the one to go. The only thing is, if I could get some budget in the bank, I would then probably upgrade Bennett to someone a bit more attacking in another team. So that is the place we are at the moment for my team. Let me know how your team did over game week 13 in the comments down below. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell and that like button if you've enjoyed this video. And also, I promise to try and stream as soon as possible. I know I haven't streamed in a while, but just the youngest daughter is at a stage now where she needs a lot of attention, so I'm getting... And with it almost being the Christmas period, I'm struggling for time a bit more than usual. So the streams should come back over the Christmas period. There may be more streams and videos purely because the fixtures will start coming thick and fast. So I'll just get streams in when I can. And also go check out my Instagram and Twitter, because I'm planning to start doing a few more quick updates during game weeks and during the week leading up to a game week on both platforms, trying to get my social media game up a little bit. So go check out at JNO United on Twitter, and also JNO_United on Instagram for those as well. And all that being said, I've been JNO, this has been FPL Today, and remember, it's all about the game.